It should come as no surprise to anyone here today that myself, as Ward Councillor, and my team colleague, Trevor Allsford, has been inundated with strong and clear views regarding the future of Cranley Fields. Over the previous 10 years, despite the odds, Councillor Nick Walker has put up an admirable fight against developers from destroying the Cranley Fields. You may feel that the word destroy is a bit melodramatic, but destroy is what they will do. You may think the most seemingly obvious factors in planning relate to properties being overlooked or to property views being lost. In a world of planning, no one has the right to a view, and that is a harsh reality. Ultimately, in any planning application, should the developer not hear what he wants locally, he merely invokes the officers of the National Inspector, whose default position is to approve the application. He or she comes up with a superhuman reason why the local's decision is deemed correct. My colleague Trevor and I Trevor tells me a story from Brighton. With all the initiatives regarding obesity being currently in vogue, a national pizza chain planned a site facility at the gates of a secondary school. Quite rightly and repeatedly, the planning committee gave them a short thrift, only to see that decision reversed nationally. Whilst this anecdote regards a totally different issue, hopefully everyone will understand how the game is played. Setting that all aside, I believe we have the relevant and legal legitimate reasons for permanently refusing planning permission for Cranley Fields. 120 houses, 250 to 300 cars using the area already congested. 120 homes, 400 to 500 additional people at doctors' surgeries and an overcrowded QA hospital. 120 homes, 300 extra children to be found school places. The destruction of a quiet, tranquil green site. Locally, we have done enough giving Wellbourne over to housing. Trevor and myself have discussed and discounted the possibility of a village green claim scenario, but alternatively, we are aware of potential means of protecting land through the planning system. The new local green space designation empowers local communities to protect spaces of local importance without the need to meet strict statutory criteria. Sites may be designated for a variety of reasons, including their setting, nature conservation benefits, or their quietness. Local communities will be able to identify green spaces through their local and neighbourhood plans, which will then receive protection equivalent to the Greenbelt ruling out of development rather than in very special circumstances.
Thank you, Councillor.